ordinance, we do intend on filing September the 1st. After the 1st, we will have 180 days to collect 20,000 signatures of City of Dallas registered voters. They have to be current registered voters in order for them to count. What we're asking for is for everybody in this room and anybody that you know who is interested in changing the way that things are handled in Dallas, you'll be called upon in the next couple of weeks, days, to help us with this campaign. So we would like to go over some of the basics of what to expect when you're going out looking for signatures. One of the things that once you come to a DCOC, Dallas Communities Organizing for Change meeting, you will receive either a folder or like a binder and a clipboard. In it, you'll find this sheet, which is for anybody that you come across that wants to help get their name, their phone number, and their email address. With this, you'll give it to somebody with DCOC in charge of contacting people so we can go ahead and get them trained, so to speak, on going out. You'll also receive a copy of the ordinance so that you can read if you haven't already, and so anybody who wants to read it before signing can do so as well. This is what the petition looks like. In order for a signature to count, we must have their name printed clearly, their signature, the date it was signed, the date of birth or their voter registration number, a phone number, and their address and zip code. It has to match their driver's license, which has to match the voter registration card. So if somebody says that it's out of date, if somebody says that it's out of date, then try to get them registered as soon as possible. We do have a couple of people who are deputies and registering people to vote. And if you're a gorilla like me, I have some that I carry around that I will give to people so that they can register to vote and they can send it off themselves, just to be sure that every vote counts. Now, we are aiming for more than needed because, of course, we know that there may be a possibility of them wanting to throw some out. So, anybody want to volunteer in role-playing how to get signatures?
I'll do it, just to help you.
Okay.
Hi, I'm with the Communities Organizing for Change, and I'd like you to... what we're doing, we're collecting signatures to kind of stop the abuse that citizens of Dallas are experiencing with police shootings, and then there's no accountability. The police are not being held responsible for some of the shootings, which were obviously done. They weren't necessary. Mm-hmm. It was more force than was needed, and there's no one to hold them accountable. Just like in a few other cities, they do have citizens review boards where citizens have the power to look at these cases case by case, call for evidence, etc. And we don't have that, and we need to get it on the ballot. So we're collecting signatures of registered voters. So if you would be willing to,
where also?
So just give us your name, print your name here, your signature, and give us the date. Today's date is the 18th, your date of birth, phone number, and address, zip code. So I have a question now. Isn't that going to set off alarms? Is there anything they can do without, since this is a legal petition, they have to have the date of birth and stuff,
date of birth or voter registration number.
Okay,
since
voter registration ID.
Yeah, since most people don't have that voter ID, we'll ask for their date of birth.
Okay, and that validates them when they go through it.
Yes, it'll. And just in case you have John Williams, you know we're gonna have a lot of John Williams in the system that will be able to go through.
Do we need to sign this ourselves?
Oh, not yet, because the signature process hasn't started yet. But you did one, now let's do another one.
It's different cases when you go out and get the signatures. It's different scenarios. Like me, I did that on purpose. I was patient enough to listen to them, you know, listen to what you had to say.
But sometimes
there are people out there like that, right? You know, there are people who don't really care at all. Then you have people who care a little bit, but they may be in you also had a patient person there to sit there and dialogue with you and ask you, you know, what made you come up with this, you know, who you were part of, if you hadn't explained it already.
Well, I'll be the impatient person ready to go and give us an example of how you handle that.
Good afternoon, sir. My name's Cassandra, and I'm with Dallas Community.
Can you just cut to the chase? What is it?
Oh, well, I'm trying to get signatures here to stop the police shootings. We're trying to get a citizens review board called the Office of the Police Monitor that would prosecute officers that use excessive force as well as kill people. Would you be interested in signing?
Yeah, I understand, but if I can just sign it real quick. And
mm-hmm.
Go, right.
Just be sure to fill out every block completely.
Date of birth? Oh, no, I can't give my personal information out. Is there any way I can do this without knowing?
Do you have your voter ID number?
No,
you can put
that
instead.
I don't have that with me.
It's just that the city requires these legalities in order to be able to confirm your identity, because they want to be sure that we're not just making up names and addresses of people, or that we're not using dead people, for example, like certain candidates have done in the past.
What about my phone number? Do you have to have that?
I mean, you can put one that... Do you know an old number you want? It's not really necessary. If you can put a number down there, we are keeping this information for future references in case that we have another campaign or if there's like a promotion. You never know, we might give some free stuff away.
And you're not selling the phone?
No, we're not selling
it,
no. No, everything here is local in Dallas, and this is for us in order to be able to get this petition, this ordinance on the ballot. And you can even go to this website and read more about it if you like.
Okay. Yeah, so that tells me a lot about how to turn those questions around.
Okay. Now let's do one, and I'll be another type of person.
Yes, I understand you're busy. We're all busy, so it's such a busy day. It's slow as a Monday. But I gotta have a few seconds
what are
of
you
time. Yes, what I have here is a petition here from Dallas Community Organizing for Change, a legitimate organization, a coalition of people who are acting to fight and combat police terrorism. What we here have, we have a petition in which we need 20,000 signatures, and within 180 days, and we need you to sign if you support organizations who are fighting to combat police terrorism. This is called Office of Police Monitor, and what this here is going to replace the current Dallas Review Board that doesn't have any power to prosecute any wrongdoers by police officers. So if you support the Office of Police Monitor to be able to implement this to hold police accountable for any wrongdoings in the community with any problems with the youth, elderly, or anything that matter, which we have seen all across the country and
well,
the city.
If we have one now, why do we need a new one?
Well, the one right now has any power to prosecute, it has any power to investigate, it has to basically wait on the investigation from the internal affairs, and that could take up to 2 or 3 years or 200 years, and the community has to wait. But this here does, it gives the community the power to be able to investigate alongside the internal affairs and suggest to city manager's office in Dallas district attorneys any recommendations prosecutorial power on those police officers involved in any civil rights violations or any murders.
But I'm a good citizen, I don't gotta worry about this.
Well, yes, well, a lot of people have been good citizens. There's been cases where individuals were murdered in handcuffs, wasn't any threat to the police officers, and they were just going about their day, but they found some confrontation or some bias that they used to, get into it with those individuals. And now those individuals' lives are taken and their families are mourning. So,
like my cousin's baby daddy, they
us.
Killed him and he was just driving along. My cousin's baby daddy, he wasn't doing nothing. They pulled him over, beat him, and then they gave him a concussion. He died. So, yeah, I'll sign it. Anybody else? Okay, so... That's, you know, and you're not going to be successful with everybody. Some people are going to flat out say, I don't care. And that's the bad thing about our communities. A lot of times people don't care until it happens to them. Mm-hmm. So when you come across somebody who says, I just don't care, tell them, well, you know what? Don't wait until it's your brother, until it's your husband or your kid, your child who's out there who gets killed late and they let him die, bleed out to death. Don't wait until then. Then it'll be too late and you're going to wish you would have done something about it.